As a climax to their 42nd anniversary celebration of scouting in America, Boy Scouts in San Francisco lend their motto, Be Prepared, to the recommissioning of the USS Intrepid. The mighty carrier has been demothballed, a fighting ship that has a great record. Its guns sank or damaged hundreds of enemy aircraft. Scout Krasna presents a replica of the Liberty Bell, symbol of Boy Scout Week, to the ship's complement. Prepared for any emergency.
I spent 4 years in the Marine Corps and was in the aerology department. Served with the 1st Marine Air Wing in Iwakuni, Japan, and then 2nd Marine Air Wing at Cherry Point, North Carolina. I love airplanes, and that's why I'm here.
So on the flight deck, you'll see a nice mixture of Navy, Air Force, Marine Corps, and Army machines, plus foreign airplanes from five different countries. This is our A-12 Blackbird, and I'm really happy that we have one of these here. Very unique airplane. This is our F-11F Tiger in Blue Angel markings. This is the TBM Avenger, designed by Grumman and built by Eastern Aircraft Division of General Motors in New Jersey. And this airplane was really one of the primary torpedo bombers for the U.S. Navy in World War II. Yeah, Intrepid has a really long history, starting in 1943, World War II. She saw a lot of action during that time, and then after the war, she kind of missed the Korean War. She was being refitted, but she served in the Cold War. Then into the 1960s, space was the big thing, and the Intrepid was on two space recovery missions, one of the Mercury missions and the very first Gemini mission. Well, here we are in front of the Enterprise. And this is really the jewel of the collection right now. This is where the most focus is at. And it's right here on the flight deck of the USS Intrepid.
Our pier was getting to the point where it was no longer safe for visitors. So the museum decided, well, if we had to close for the complete reconstruction of the pier, that we would go ahead and take the ship out and do a complete renovation and rehabilitation of the ship.
The entire project received a significant amount of funding from federal, state, and local governmental sources, so in excess of $80 million. We were just providing a little over $7 million to help them operate with the skeletal staff while the ship was being renovated. They didn't have any exhibits, the museum wasn't open, but they needed to keep their key employees, their core staff, in place to plan for when the ship would be returned.
Zions Bank Public Finance really helped us walk through the whole process, made it very smooth, what the product offerings were that were available to us at the time, what was the easiest and most cost-effective way to accomplish what we needed to.
Well, I love being at Intrepid, this grand old ship, all these wonderful airplanes, the wonderful employees that are here. I just love coming to work every day, but I got to say, the most important thing about coming here is meeting the guys who served on the ship or flew the airplanes. Getting to know those Intrepid sailors and airmen, that's the best part of my job.
The opportunity to spend time with our former crew members, who are just such an important part of our family and the fabric of the experience here at the museum. They bring life to the experience here at the museum.
It's a facility that can show the young people from the development of the aircraft carriers up until the space shuttle. It's a great facility to connect the young people with what's happened in aviation. It could probably be put to sea if they wanted to, but it just symbolizes a great time in our country's history.